Marine scientist Megan Johnson is fighting a battle few ever see. She's slowly bringing Florida's coral reefs back to life. 30 feet below the surface, Johnson showed me row after row of coral alive and growing after decades of being battered by disease and warmer water.
Amazing.
Amazing because all of it was planted here by scientists.
These are actually fragments that started off about this size that were brought into the nursery and have grown.
They started out a couple of inches.
3 years later, this is what it looks like.
No, we've never done it.
It all started in Ken Niedermeyer's backyard in the Florida Keys. His daughter needed a 4-H project, so they decided to try growing coral.
If I'd read any books, I think I probably wouldn't have started because everybody would have said, no, you can't do that. That won't work.
Their technique worked so well, researchers adopted it. And 9 years later, it has spawned this, the largest man-made nursery project, with 5,000 coral colonies growing underwater from Fort Lauderdale to the Virgin Islands. Scientists clip new coral just like pruning a tree, then plant it with a special underwater glue. When it's big enough, it's moved to a reef to replace dead or dying coral.
It's just amazing what happens. A lot more habitat for fish, for juvenile fish, for large fish, for invertebrates.
But they're now facing a new threat, BP oil. Every day, Megan Johnson anxiously checks the forecast for the Gulf Loop Current, the system that seasonally carries water and anything in the water east through the Florida Keys.
It's definitely devastating to see what's happening in the Gulf and knowing that that could come here. I think we're all definitely worried about what's going to happen in this project.
There's little they can do to protect the nurseries. But if the oil is weathered and weakened enough, Johnson thinks the young coral just might pull through.
You sit down there, aren't they cute?
Yeah, they are. Those are our little babies, you know. We put those guys out there and it's nice to come back in a month or two and see them actually growing and feel like, wow, I did that. I'm helping, I'm doing something good.
Even with oil looming a few hundred miles away, she's hopeful at least some of that good will survive. Kelly Cobiella, CBS News, off the Florida Keys.